Hey, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time of day it is that you are watching me, Brady Theodore, on my YouTube channel. You can reach out to me at bradytheodore.com. Today, I want to give you a little tip or a hack that I use when I want to capture pictures or videos from my computer screen, no matter where they're at, any social media site, on YouTube, just any place. It's a little tool that I use when I need to find a picture or video and then capture it to use within my videos or on my social media sites. And before I get into that little tip and that little trick, I'd like you to go below, subscribe to my channel, touch the bell, be notified when I come back on and give you more tips and tricks. Anyway, let's dive right on into this. I'm going to share my screen, and first and foremost, I will put my glasses on so I can see what I'm doing. I'm going to share my screen now. Let's see. I will share my screen, so I say. Give me 1 second here, folks. And I'm going to share, and I'm going to share this with sound so you can pick up the sound of the video also. Here I'm sharing my screen. This just happens to be the front of my computer. Now, the tool that I use is called TinyTake by Mango Apps. Something that somebody showed me a little over a year ago that I have been using. Right here, TinyTake by Mango Apps. It's going to come up. I hope. Oops, there it is. This is a free tool. There is a paid version that does quite a bit more, but for what I use it for, when I capture regions of videos or videos themselves, I may want to use it as a backdrop within my videos. I may see a picture that I like, a meme. I want to. There's no way of downloading it. Maybe I just want a portion of the picture or the video, a little close-up, whatever it may be. This is a great free tool that allows you to do exactly what you are trying to do, which is find content and use it in the way that you want to use it for. So anyway, and here's my Mango Apps. I'm going to bring up right now, this is my Facebook page. This is a picture. I'm just going to use it as an example. This is my personal logo. So what you would do is open your Mango app, and right over here it says capture. You see you've got a number of options. You can get regions. You can click it and just get the full window, screen, all these different options that you have. For this little hack, this is for copying a picture. So I'm going to do a region. So when you click that, you see these little crosshairs come up. Do not touch your mouse button. Do not click on it, because once you do, it will snap the photo. So if you look to the left of the B, I want to have a nice little centered edge. If you look over here to the right of the E, I just want to judge exactly where I want to have the crosshairs, top and bottom also. So I want just a hair off the B, a little bit above the BT. Now I'm going to left click. I'm going to drag this, and I'm going to get just to the E, so I've got about the same gap, the top and bottom, about the same area, and you release the button, and you've saved the picture. That easy. Now, you have the option, when you file this, you can save it online. Of course, Mango Apps is going to suggest that you do that because they want to hold your information. I like to save these locally in my files because I have better access to it. So right over here, you can save it to TinyTake. You can save it locally. I save it locally. I go under my pictures, and I'm just going to name this what it was, BT Brady. And you can see it comes up as a PNG. I'm going to save it. And the PNGs are what you can use most anywhere. So I'm going to close that up. let's say you are trying to make a video and you want a motion backdrop for it, and you don't want the whole GIF and the URL, you don't want all the extra information, you just want a little bit of the video itself. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to minimize that. I've got YouTube open and I've got a little cartoon up here. Now when I start this, of course, it's, you will hear the sound, but this is here. I'm going to go to my Mango apps and open it. I'm on the video. I go to capture. It says capture video. I click on this. I've got my crosshairs. I can set this within the region I want to capture, which would be right in there. I don't want to have, you see on the lower right, it's got the little logo. Maybe I don't want the logo. Now release the button on the mouse, and you see it's picking up my sound. It's not recording at the moment. You can say start recording. Start the video.
Oh, that George! It found him!
Hey, George. I thought...
Stop the video. Finish recording. And right here, now you've got the video, and you can test it out. Start the video.
Oh, that George! It found him!
So we just did a little short piece. Hey, we didn't want to stop the video. You see in the video, I had my mouse moving. You don't want to be scrolling around and moving because it picks up everything within the capture screen. So from here, again, I like to save these locally, not online. I do not want to save it to my TinyTake app. You can if you like. I find it better and easier for myself to save locally. I want to save this under my videos. You can put it in any file that you want. You can rename it anything that you need. I'm just going to write George because I know it's a little curious George video clip. I'm going to save it. I can then close that. And if I come down here to my files, I go into my pictures. I'm lost. Sorry, folks. There it is. And I can see BT Brady right there is the picture that I saved, and you have it. This opens up in my other little program where I can put in maybe a domain name, whatever I want to add to the picture, and I can save it. But anyway, there's my picture that's saved for future use. I can go to my videos, and I had that named George, and it's right there. You can open that up, and you can see that it's going to play for me here in the correct format. Now, what I do personally is I move these.
Start the
stop this. Stop the video. There's that. I am going to stop sharing my screen. I do believe right there. And I'm back. Anyway. Now, what I do with my pictures and videos is I may move them over to my phone. I have a little video editing app that I use for my Facebooks and my YouTube videos. And sometimes I like to do an overlay onto a video that I've captured. So I move it over to my phone. You can use it any way that you want. But anyway, that's a neat little tool that I heard about a year ago when I was struggling and trying to find out a way to save these pictures and videos for future use. So that's my little tip, trick, hack of the day, TinyTake by Mango Apps. Now, if you enjoy any of my videos, any of my tips, tricks, and hacks, please go below, subscribe to my channel, touch the bell, be notified when I come on again, and I will continue to come in daily, weekly, and monthly and give more value and information to all my friends on YouTube. Again, thank you so much, and I will see you all real soon.